Hello friends, how are you doing? I hope you all are doing very good wherever you are. Today I want to tell you the things which shocked me when I came to Germany. I have lived in many countries, first India, then Italy, Ireland, Singapore, Australia, and then I moved to Germany. But I have also seen many countries as a tourist, from USA to Japan, number of the countries I have visited as a tourist. But Germany has shocked me in every way it could. Before moving into details, I will request you to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. It will motivate me to post further content on the YouTube. First thing which shocked me when I moved to Germany was concept of no Sunday shopping. On Sunday, all shops are closed. And why it is on top of my list? Because that was the first thing. I came here, landed here on Sunday with my children and my husband, and there was no shop to buy milk. All shops were closed, and I moved here from Singapore. In Singapore, shopping is 24/7, and here on Sunday, all shops were closed. Restaurants were also not open all through the day, so I could buy pizza also only in the evening when pizza shop opened. So it was my first shocker. Secondly, in Germany, no means no. In India, if a guest comes to my house, we don't even ask, we just make tea and serve the tea with snacks. And the guest will say no, 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 and we will still say no, you have to take, please take a little bit more, please take a little bit more. And the guest will say, as a courtesy, we say, oh no, no, I don't want it, but we will keep on insisting, no, you have to take it. But in Germany, if a guest says no, it means no. He will get offended if you will keep on insisting to eat or tea. That I really like it a lot. Even if I go to someone's house and someone asks me, do you want coffee? And I say no, then he will not ask me again. In the beginning, it was a bit shocker because it is our tradition. It is as a part of courtesy. We are supposed to say no first time, and then it is a little bit of yes only. And that I really liked it, because this no means no thing flows through every aspect of the society, from dating, from personal life to the professional life, in the office, in your social circles. People are really mature enough, they have that confidence that if they don't want something, they say no, and that no has to be respected. I really like this cultural aspect of Germany. Third shocker for me was dressing rooms in fitness centers or in swimming pool. Here there is no concept of changing rooms. Separation of cabins is just not there. People take baths as a group in a big shower area, or they are just roaming around without clothes in the locker room. Yeah, there is a separate men's locker room and a separate women locker room. But if it is a sauna for both genders, then men and women will be just sitting without clothes. They don't feel embarrassed about this. All other nationalities, even if it is from USA or Mexico, Romania, UK, Italian, they all are a little bit, they want their privacy. They all feel awkward, but Germans are very natural about it. There is no staring at all at such places. Germans really take their body in a natural way. Which takes me to my fourth point, which also shocked me a lot, and it shocks every other nationality, is the concept of Frei Körperliche Kultur. So near about in all the beaches or in the parks, there is a small area, secluded area, where some group of people will be taking sun bath or having a picnic without any clothes on. From all age groups, from all the religions or whatever, they will be just sitting there without any clothes at all. For me, it was a big shocker that they are really so natural, even in the free air, free space, they'll be just sitting like this. Actually, there is a brief history. There is a reason why they started this type of culture. Some people turned to this type of habit because at the time of Cold War, there was a lot of supervision going on the people, especially in the DDR, Russian occupied Germany. So when they got freedom, they wanted to show themselves as free from all types of barriers. So they took out their clothes as a token to show their freedom. Not all Germans practice this type of culture. There is only a very small section of the people. They are also called naturalists, but that is how they are. But they don't create any sort of problem, any sort of tensions during in their surroundings. They just stay within their group and in a very elegant way. So next shocker for me here was beer culture. People drink beer here instead of water. If I see someone walking on the street with a bottle in hand, that bottle will be of beer, not of water. To be fair, that beer here, beer doesn't have that much of alcohol percentage, and people drink wine with food, and no matter how much beer and wine they take, they maintain their sensibilities. They don't cross their boundaries. I've also lived in Ireland, and there also drinking beer culture was a lot, but not as much as here it is. And in offices or in other places, if they are not drinking beer, because they will not drink alcohol in offices, so there they are drinking carbonated water. They will not drink still water, that is like plain water, flat water. There will be some fizz in it. I even asked my doctor about it, that is there any health benefit to it, that why they don't drink it, and the doctor said no, it is just our habit that we don't drink flat water, but there is absolutely no health benefit. So that is why I was a bit surprised that they like this. Even kids, they will not drink water, they will drink Apfelschorle, which means apple juice with carbonated element in it. So that is why water drinking is very rare in here, and they don't normally drink tap water. They prefer either mineral water bottles or something like that, but that also obviously carbonated mineral water bottles. So next shocker for me here was number of taxes. Cost of living is not so high in Germany, like cost of groceries or cost of renting and something like that. But number of taxes we have to pay, number of insurances we have to take just to survive here in Germany is horrendous. Taxes really rob a very huge chunk of your salary. And number of insurances, there are medical insurances, there are third liability insurances, there are house equipment insurances. There are really a number of insurances that every person has to take. So after all the taxes and insurances, there is not much amount of the salary left. So bank accounts are not so much overflowing with the money, but we, just because we pay so much taxes and there are insurances, so we have a sense of security and stability in life, especially at the time of this lockdown. So many people have lost their jobs. There is decrease in the income of so many people. But still, this idea that my child can go to the school without any problem, because education here is free. And if I get sick, I can go to the hospital without worrying about the cost of the medical facilities. So it is very, very important. And that is why here stress is not so much. And even if I get stressed, even if I get sick, the amount of sick leave, there is unlimited amount of sick leave. The doctors can give me the certificate that yes, she is sick, and then I can stay at home till I get recovered properly. So even the things like stress and depression is not brushed off under the carpet. They really take it seriously, and because of all these taxes and insurances, we really have a very good quality of life, and for me that is more important. So next shocker for me, especially in this time of the year, is the people blowing noses in the public. They really blow their nose very loudly in the public. And we in our culture, and even in Asia, yeah, in Japan also, I have seen, in Singapore I have seen, that people will just keep on doing like this, because we are so afraid of blowing our nose in the public. And we will go to the washroom, but we will not go sitting in a group of people. But here people will really clear up their nose instead of creating disturbance in the whole group doing like this. And even my German teacher commented on that Asians have a big problem, that they will not clear their nose at once. Instead, they will keep on doing like this and create a irritation in the whole environment. So from their point of view, Germans do a very, they don't feel awkward about their bodily functions. They just do it and rather clean their nose at once and then stay quietly and silently in the whole time in the work group. In Germany, I get shocked and mesmerized by hundred of things. But one of the things which has shocked me the most here in Germany is the friendliness of the people. And why it is such a big shocker for me, because before moving to Germany permanently, I never even thought of coming here as a tourist, because there is so wide perception about Germans that they are arrogant, they are rude, they will not speak to you in English, even if you are dying, they will stick to their German and they are very cold in nature. But what I found here personally, it is totally different. They are so motivating, they are so supporting, because here I learned German from scratch. And they were so full of motivation, and they were saying, no, you are doing good, you are doing good. They will try to understand. If I will speaking wrong German in some other countries, sometimes we get mocked at, like, look, Indian accent or something like that. But here, if I speak even broken German, the Germans will try to understand it, and they will still encourage to keep getting better at the language. So this friendliness, if I am stuck at somewhere on the road or in the train station, they will help me with the directions, they will take their time, they will be patient, and they will make sure that I understand and I got the help which was needed. I will actually say that the reason why I was able to settle here in Germany so well, and why we want to settle here permanently, is that the basic reason that here Germans are so friendly and so cooperative, so nice. These people have helped us to actually learn so many more things in life, not only language, but also how to help the other people, even if that person is feeling down. So these were the things which shocked me most about Germany. There are 100 of other things. I can cover them also in my other video. So these were some of the things which shocked me about Germany when I moved here at first. But there are 100 of other things. Please write to me in the comment box if you want to learn about also those things. And please tell me if you like the video, what were your opinions about Germany? And do you also live in Germany? Then what is your perception about living in Germany? If you like my video, please hit the like button. Share it with your family and friends so that they can also know something about Germany. And do subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. I will see you in my next video. Till then, take very good care of yourself. Stay healthy, stay happy, and stay blessed. Bye-bye.